Aha!
This is what I was after, guys. A new mount, and one that is truly majestic. Oh, what is going on, guys? Unite the Clans here, back in your life with another episode of Ark Survival Evolved. And today we are hopefully going to be heading into that snow biome. You can see I'm freezing my butt off up here on 03. At some point I'll give you guys an update on what's been going on. Ba-boom. Today I have taming in mind, and I would like to tame a mighty mount. Raptors are fine, Carnos are fine, Flyers are fine, but I want a mount that shows off the majesty that is Unite the Clans. We'll see. So what I'm going to do is leave Zero here, and I will head back to the Maw, the big central community area, and I'm going to borrow an Argentavis, and then we're going to head into those woods and capture the beast that I would like to tame. I will be back with you guys in just a minute. Alright guys, we are back at spawn here, and there's an Argentavis I was hoping to borrow. Yes, this guy. I borrowed him in the past, and he should be able to help us get the job done and tame the majestic mount I want, but one of our guys on the server, Monkey Puzzle, who is one of the bigger YouTubers on the server, he just let me know that he went to donate in my housewarming gift box, and it's full. I guess people have been super generous. Super generous. That is a lot of medium animal feces. I have to wonder if Monkey Puzzle may be responsible for that. If not, and he's just wandered into a box full of poop, that's one thing. So I'm going to hop on this Argentavis on loan, I think from the last time I borrowed her, and I will head back to my place in the mountains, which I've called the Argy's Nest. And from there, we will set off to build like a little taming pen, and then to scoop up the creature I want to tame and drop it in there so we can tame the beast. I'm going to leave all that poop there. I don't have a whole lot of use for it now. My guys on the server are so sweet. So, guys, I thought I'd bring you back for part of the journey. I don't think I'm that far from my place. I think it's just on the other side of this mountain. And I thought I'd take a second and update you on what's been going on with me and going on with the server here. I have set up camp, as you saw, on Craig's Island, and I've got big plans for that place. I want to, if I can, build an entire village there. I'm thinking castle, churches, tons of houses. It's a big undertaking, and we'll see. Because at some point, these Iron Mine crew, they're deep into Season 2. And at some point, they'll want to start Season 3, which will mean a server restart. So whatever I do, I want to get done while we still got the time. So that's what's on my mind. And we got regular collaborations coming up in the near future with a couple other guys on the server. I have mentioned this before too, but SW Chris and Mick Mastodon are two of the guys on the server and two of the ones I was hoping I'd get an opportunity to work with. And it looks like that opportunity is gonna come, and it's hopefully gonna come once a week. We got together this week and we started work on a big project, a Gallimimus racetrack. Now, if you guys don't know, you might know, I tried to tame them earlier on in my Ark series, but the Gallimimus is about the fastest land creature there is. And I gotta remember where my little stone house is. I always get lost around here. Let's have a look at the map. I think it is this way. But yeah, we started working on a Gallimimus racetrack, and sort of a big cross-country course. That is going to be fun, and we're going to continue to explore that. It seems like it's going to be a neat thing. I might be over there doing some building in episodes coming up soon. We'll definitely have the one where Chris and Mick and I work on the track, and then I'm solo working on some stables for the beasts. There are a lot of Argentavis around here, eh? You gotta be careful. You gotta be cautious. I gotta find my base. That's gonna take me a sec. I might just circle this mountain while I talk. But guys, I have not been holding true lately to my video a day New Year's resolution. I wanted 365 videos in 2016. I never planned to play catch up, so if I miss a day, it's just missed. But I do want to keep trying it. And I think the problem is Ark. In two ways. One, the reason I stopped playing it the first time around was because every episode took me 3 hours to record a good 20-minute episode. My base must be close to here, okay? Yeah, I'm on the wrong damn side of the mountain. Keep going around it, I guess. I'll go over it. Let's go over it. I think I know where I'm headed. I'm gonna have to land this beast soon. But yeah, part of the problem is that the game, doing things in the game, let's say I want to do a building video. Let's see, will you land here? Yes, you will. A building video, it takes me time to prepare and get ready to go, to gather all the resources I need. For a taming video, I mean, you have to have those resources too. You gotta have those resources? Yeah, let's fly. And you have to have the time and the patience to build on camera. And so that is one thing. The other is that I am more in love with this game now than I have ever been. And I keep hopping on to play, and I just play way too long, and I just play aimlessly, and I'm having so much fun doing it that I get distracted, and I end up it being 1 in the morning, and I haven't recorded a damn thing yet. So that happens. So those are the reasons why I think now that I'm set up on the server, I have some basic animals and a basic base. It's going to be easier and easier for us to, for me to just sit down and record a video for you guys. And with the weekly get together with Chris and Mick, we'll have that content coming at you most weeks. Where the hell is my base? I gotta go find it. I'll look around until I find it, and then we'll set off in search of the creature that we're hoping to tame today. Yeah, expect lots of building episodes as we go forward. Expect some other cool stuff along the way. I think it's just out here by these trees, just on the other side of this beacon, I'm pretty sure. Yep, I feel good about this. It can be hard to find your place if you get a new place far from home. But this is the bird we need to do it today. Yeah, I will try and get back to daily videos. I'll try and get back to building with UTC in Minecraft. I'll try and keep the videos of life in the woods coming to you. Now, those are challenging for me to make because I try and knock a giant thing off my to-do list with every episode. Here we are, we're back. Pretty sweet. Okay. So I'll land and we'll actually set out, I think, if this guy'll stay here, and he will, we'll set out to start construction. Put that damn map book away, you nerd. Start some construction on a little taming pen. And then I will debut to you, unless I made it the episode thumbnail. Can I leave anything important here? I'll just take this stuff just in case. I use the bed to fast travel. We'll grab our proper armor, because we're heading into dangerous territory. Here, I'll do that. Yeah, I'm gonna build a little taming pen, and that's something I've never really done. Everything I've ever tamed, I've kind of hunted down in the wild, tranked it, and then chased it down. All right, flak leg. I think we're good. Throw this stuff in here, and I'll grab my real tools. Like that. Yeah, we'll build a little taming pen, and then with the Argentavis, by the way, I got a gun. And we got Trank arrows nearby here too. Come on, put it all in there. What am I doing wrong? There we go. Take a parachute, because you never know. Take my crossbow back, my spyglass. I'll take all this. Yeah, I've never messed around really with a taming pen, so that's something we're gonna do today. We're gonna hopefully make a little 2x1 pen, hop in there, grab the beasts we want, and dump them in there. You know what? To be honest, I don't know why I'm keeping this secret. I will almost definitely have a clip of me riding him at the beginning of the episode, and I will almost definitely have a clip of me riding him at the end of the episode, and he'll be in the thumbnail. So I think we're gonna tame the Megaloceros, which is it's basically an elk, moose, caribou, a giant antlered beast. Now, the males have antlers, the females are a little faster and don't have antlers, but the male's the majestic looking one. That's what I was going for. Now, my original plan before I thought of grabbing the Argentavis was to build this on the fly, which means I just went with, like, wherever I knock the animal out, then follow up and build a little thing around him. So I just grabbed these fence foundations, which can be a bit hard to see. Whoops, get that rifle off here. I can craft rifles now. I still have the one that was given to me by Cryo. And I made a ton of Trank darts, which is going to be pretty sweet too. So that's hopefully how we're going to take the beast down. Here, why don't you give me a minute? I'll hammer out this pen, and we'll probably be just about ready for a break. The snow biome is one that you guys have barely, if ever, seen on my series. life is very different up here. You got dire wolves, saber cats, mammoths, a ton of Argentavises, woolly rhinos, which I swear I just saw one. Yes, there he is. Okay. Woolly rhino. Whoops. And if I'm not mistaken, the creature we're after is right here as well. A majestic-looking antlered beast. Where are you? There. Level 48. You know what? I might keep looking, but the problem is I'm not really geared up for this kind of weather. So we're gonna try to just fly over, scoop this fool up, and try not to. Come on. I haven't scooped anybody before, so try to line it up. Yes, I got him. I got him. All right, now let's make our getaway quick. Oh, pretty sweet. It doesn't really look like I'm holding on to him, but I'm gonna fly him back up to my base where life's a little warmer. And then I might go looking around for a slightly better one. We'll see. We'll see. But for the time being, I like him and I like the look of him. All right. I did it? I think I did it. All right, first try. Land. Yes, first try puts him in there. We'll be able to trank him through there. Let me warm up, guys. I'll see if I can find a better one, and if not, we'll come back to taming this level 48 as soon as I get the chance. Freezing and starving. Yeah, I gotta get my shit together. All right, hopefully he keeps it in there. I put more walls up. He kept hopping the edges. Okay, guys, I'm gonna go gather some berries, just some basics. None of that stuff really grows up here. So I'll go on a little hunt for food. We've now got this guy trapped, and once I got enough food, we'll trank him, and then we'll set up a couple campfires just inside here so that we and it stay warm, and hopefully he doesn't escape while I'm out on berry hunt. Oh, and you can see, yeah, the chat is active. Everybody on the server this afternoon. It's a gorgeous Sunday afternoon. I personally have had a great day. Sat out on my deck, cup of coffee, and I had the Toronto Blue Jays baseball playing on the radio. Very old school. I live in an old farmhouse, and there's something about listening to a baseball game on the radio. Jays win, beat the Red Sox, advance to 500. That's my team. We had a great year last year, but it's honestly, it's a funny thing. The listening to it on the radio, I think it's the way that they broadcast it, but for me, it's almost better. The picture in my mind of the game, just having to imagine it and fill in the blank spots. And you've got this longtime sort of play-by-play guy for the Jays. I think his name's Jerry Howarth. He's been around forever. And the way he does it, he has got it so down. He gives you sort of, he gets across the emotion and the sort of appearance of the player. You know what I mean? Where he tells you as they're look, you know, at the right time, he tells you just about the right thing to give you an image of what the player's like and what they're doing. You know, he leans in to see the sign from the catcher, or he doesn't like that ball, tosses it away, grabs a new one, rubs it down, tries to compose himself, blah, blah, blah. And it's just like that gets you into it. You have this vision in your brain. And it kind of inspires me a little bit. I know a lot of what I do is video, and you guys seeing this, but at the same time, I talk not just about the game. I talk about life, a lot of the time, my life, your life, who knows what. And we got enough berries now? I think that should be enough for a low-level guy like him. We'll come back and tame a better one if we like him, but I just want to get a basic one tamed up. So let's fly up there, and we'll see if we can trank this fool through the window. Oh, where are all my tranks? Hold on one sec. I might have left him inside. Let's see. Land. Hop off. Okay. Yeah, it's funny. A level 100 Argentavis is so much better than anything I have, or you know what I mean? I mean, I could tame a better one, but I was asking if I could borrow this guy, and people are like, "Oh yeah, he's low level. Go for it." I'm like, "Low level? He's 100. It's pretty good for me." I swear I had 15 darts. 21 darts. We're good. Okay. Okay, let's attempt this. Now, I want to have ORG close, just in case this beast does manage to get up and over the wall. Yeah, you can see Gil, who's the guy who gave me 02, who sadly died doing what he loved, though. He got killed by a Carno, who I then tamed. So I have his, the guy who killed him, tamed. So I'm thinking we'll shoot this guy through the windows. Let's try it out. So Gil's on there, Lady M, who you guys met in the first episode, and Monkey Puzzle, who I was talking up, who I think gave me that big old pile of poop. All right, let's aim for the head. Maybe if the head's sticking out, it'll be easier. Okay. Oh, stick your head out. Stick your head out, fool. Ready? Get tranked. Get tranked. Okay, he's down. He's down. All right. Now we hop in. Close this door. Did I grab any spark powder? Do I have anything to burn in my fires? I don't. Okay. So we'll start off by getting him sedated, which, where the hell? Uh-oh, I hope I haven't forgotten that. Okay, well, let's fill him full of berries, and I'm gonna hurry to go find some spark powder and some. And I should close this just in case. I'm gonna go find some spark powder to get my fire going, and I'm gonna grab some narcotics to keep this guy out. I know I got both those things. I was prepared for this episode. Yes, I do. And, yes, I do. Okay, cool. We're good to go, guys. We are good to go. We ain't gonna freeze to death even if it pours rain on us. And I guess I could show you off this build if this is a slow tame. We'll see. We'll see about that. You know, it's actually building the racetrack that had me thinking about the other fast mounts you can get on this island. Once we started working on the Gallimimus track, I was like, hey, well, why not race, you know, raptors or parasaurs or saber-tooth or direwolves or these things, any of the fast mounts in the game. And I mean, I'd love to even do a, so we'll light one, and I think these multiply, so although we're not cold, so we'll wait to light the other one, and we will narc this guy up. And which berries is he eating? I'll give him all of them. I'll have a quick Google job, and I'll see which ones are the best. Guys, why don't I come back to you when we're closer to taming this guy? I'll come back when he's tamed, and then hopefully we can scoop him up with Argy, grab 03, and head back to Craig's Island, where we'll make a saddle and ride this beast. Ride him the length of the island, up and down the beaches, up and over the hills. I can't wait. Be back with you in just a minute. So it looks like he's going to be a little while. My calculator says it's going to take around 17 minutes. And obviously I don't have time to spend that whole time showing you guys around, but I'll show you the basics of this build. Let's take a little airborne look at it, to be honest. I think that's your best way of doing it. All right, K camera, and there you go. Just a little spot on top of the hill. I wanted a way to explore these sort of northern plains in the mountains. I'm not really built to make it out there. I'm not really, I need, there's some stats I have to level up before that becomes a real serious option, but we've gone and done it. This is UTC, oops, look away, the Argy's Nest, and a little entranceway, and there's a tower above us here, and then I just built a really simple stone cabin, a little bit of storage, bed, that, but my favorite part, we got a little back deck, which is sweet, and parking spot up there for Zero. It's hard to land them, but it's kind of perfect. If I land them going that way, as I dismount, I land on this little thing, and then I can just hop down. I really should build the ladder up that instead, but the way I've got it now, the ladder comes up into this little area, right? Which it's not big enough to do anything with. And then up here, and I got a little Widow's Walk type setup where I can throw out my scope and scan the lands around me for dangers and whatnot. I don't know. I like role playing these builds, and I would think if you had a spot up in the mountains, you know, not only would you have a view like this where you can take in whatever that is, the frozen fang or the frozen tooth, but you'd also want a tower for watching out. And ideally, I think you'd, if you lived out here, your two main means of transport would be an Argentavis, because they can do well up in these mountains, and there's tons of them already up here. Definitely a better than a Pteranodon for up here, because you'd be hauling metal and things like that. And then if it were me and I was traveling on the ground, I think my choice of mount would be this guy. So as much as I'd like to have him here at my base up here, I'm not here often enough to make sure he stays fed. So the way we're looking now, we're looking to add 23 levels. Now, he's just a level 48. Most of the people on the server wouldn't even bother taming a level 48, but he was the first one I saw, and, you know, if I like him, I'll go tame someone else. But, so 23 levels on a 48 would mean a 71, what, like I said, they most Monkey Puzzle was saying this level 100 is too low level to be worth it. Screw it. I like them. I'm not worried about that. Really, if it gets me from A to B and does the job, I'm not worried about. This is a mostly a PvE friendly server. Nobody's attacking each other. Nobody's outrunning each other. It's really only like for races and whatnot that you'd actually want the fastest whatever on the island. I'm wondering, I've flown around. I've seen a lot of people's bases, and I've not seen a single one with one of these megaloceruses. I'm assuming you pronounce it like rhinoceros, because that's the same ending, and it's not a dinosaur, so I know it's not a megalosaurus. Whatever. Pronunciation in this game is a real challenge. Everybody's got their own way of saying things. Nobody's actually consulting the Wikipedia or the pronunciation. We just go for it. Whatever rolls out of our mouth. Is it Argentavis? Is it Argentavis? Who knows? Actually, there's one of those is right. All right, guys. Well, I'll come back to you when this beast is tamed. Then we'll fly him out to the island, and then we'll ride him. All right? Sounds like a deal. It is almost time. Oh, it is time! Wild Megaloceros is a very skittish herbivore, found mostly in the forest, mountains. Blah, blah, blah. Runs from predators. The horns, very large, makes for an excellent source of keratin. Domesticated, jack-of-all-trades mount. Many who ride it value its versatility. Decently powerful and resilient. I think it has a charge bonus, and it has a charge attack, and it can collect thatch with its antlers, assuming you tame the male. That is pretty boss. Looks pretty frickin' elegant up there. How about that, guys? Here he is. He came out at level, what is it, 70? Here, let me turn that HUD back on. Yeah, level 70. So I'm going to scoop him up with Argy. We'll tell Zero to follow, and we will head back down the western coast over that away to Craig's Island, where we will make a saddle and mount this majestic king of the forest. And welcome back, guys, here with 03 in tow, and you can see the mighty beast attached to the back of my bird. Now, those among you who are the wisest will notice that's not the same megaloceros. You're right, I accidentally dropped the first one and killed it. So I had to go back and find another, a much higher level one, and tame him. And if we land, yes. Okay, now I'm going to hop off. Zero, I need to sit him down. Sit down! All of you, sit down. Alright. Nope. Alright, okay, we're good. Grab the saddle here. Yes. And actually, I should unload whatever I have, because I'm not sure about the carrying weight of this guy yet. Take everything I don't need. Hold on to it for now. You can have that. You can have that. I don't need this meat. I just want to make myself as light. Hey, 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 hey. Hey, what's going on? Okay, fine. Kill the raptor. Kill him. Jesus, guys. Okay, where's... Hey, hey, hey. Where are you off to? Come on. Come on. Forest King gets his first kill. Come on, boys. Get in there. Clean house. Forest King gets another kill. Oh, what a beast he is. All right. I got to put my UTC tag on him, and then we're going to mount him up, okay? Change name. I was inspired by the nonsense I talked at the end of the last segment, and I ended up naming him Forest King. All right. Who? Whoops, that's not it. Okay, and his carry weight, 270. I think I weigh less than that right now. Yes, I do. Aha! This is what I was after, guys. A new mount, and one that is truly majestic. One that can lay down a charge like that, or can just cross from one side of my island to the other. And above all else, can make me look like the truest of bosses. Let's take a look at this. Oh, yes! How good does that look? Hell yeah. I can't wait to get a couple of these, maybe get some jousting or a racetrack for these going. Oh, that would be fun. Cool. Well, guys, thank you. So, oh, is that a level up for Forest King already? Yes, it is. Beautiful. I'm going to save it until I figure out how I'm going to be leveling this beast up. Geeks, thank you so much for checking out this episode of ARK. Survival Evolved. I'm Unite the Clans, and I will see you all in the next episode. You stay cool.